سپیتن کافی کمپینی داری کافی سامکر بکشاریم جاین کنیدیم دیرکتر باش ناو جاین سایز که تو بودا داری های گود مانی سنس یو آر بیگست دیزل فیو انجکشن مینیفیکچر ایسی تاب لی آسکنگ یو خواد دیمانڈ فور دیزل میکرز هز بین لیکلی اینڈ هز یو سین انی ریکوری ایٹ آل
I think on the ground, we've not seen any major change both in the automotive market, where in 2015 it's very muted, and the overall year to date up to March, there has been a zero growth compared to the previous year. Of course, segment sales, it's different. And in case of the fast cars, while we've seen about 3 to 4% growth, the diesel, compared to the gasoline, which has marginally moved down right now, at about 42% or so, remains the same because the fuel differential between the gasoline and diesel partly determines the sentiment.
Okay, so Mr. Bhattacharya, what is FY16 looking like both for the industry as well as Dash, and what growth can you expect?
Okay, I'll have to just make a small correction that the figures of 2000 and 14-15, and we have a 15-month period, are not yet announced, so I cannot announce that number and for the company, which is Bosch Limited. And second, if you ask me a generic question on what does FY15-16 look like, I would give a generic answer for the industry and say it looks a muted year for the automotive industry. Of course, segmented analysis say that there's going to be a negative growth on tractors, there's going to be a marginal growth on perhaps on the fast cars, and there's going to be a positive double-digit growth perhaps on the HCV, but on a very low base. Overall, I would say, a very muted growth is seen in 15-16 currently in automotive, no major change.
Okay, about the latest problems and the general plans, have they been resolved with respect to the lockup?
We've given a statement on the lockout, I would stay with that, saying that the company has taken a step to ensure the interests of the employees, of the stakeholders, for the reasons as was mentioned. And we lifted the lockout, and we've announced this also to the stock exchange to ensure that there is, industrial peace and harmony, especially when some of the people were going through this strike, which was not the right thing to do. So I would say the settlement discussions are on, and the settlement discussions will need to be concluded.
Okay, and has there been any hit to production or impact on sales due to the lockout?
There has been absolutely no impact on production. We have ensured that through our officers and trainees, even the 7 days, we had our lines running, and there has been absolutely no impact on to customers or other stakeholders in any form and manner.
Okay, can you elaborate on what's happening in the non-motor business?
As I mentioned, I cannot talk about any numbers now, but if you generally ask me, the non-auto businesses that Bosch has are very varied in nature. We have power tools, we have aftermarket, and different market forces play for these non-automotive areas. We have solar, we have thermotechnic, we have security systems. So we have variety, and each of these segments are very, very different. I would say it is following the same trend as we see in the economy. There is tight liquidity in the economy today. All companies, including Bosch, watch carefully for inventories and receivables. And it's also the economy hasn't really majorly picked up. So different segments, different rates of growth, but the overall economy, as I mentioned, relatively muted on the ground.
The consumer appliances segment has been doing well. What is the expectation of growth going ahead within that segment?
The consumer markets, again, are a very different kettle of fish. Bosch, of course, has a very, very strong presence worldwide. And Bosch has started on a lower base, so naturally growth on a lower base would always be positive. However, as I said, It's early days because Bosch is a relatively new player in India. In other parts of the world, of course, Bosch is an extremely mature and mature player and has very good market shares.
Okay, can you elaborate on how your company will benefit from the implementation of the BS4 emission norm changes from FY18? Since the cost per truck is likely to rise, will that help your revenues?
Look, the emission norm changes are being discussed in terms of when they will be announced for BS4 and BS5. And they still have a 2 years, period to go, 2017. Now, emission norms, once they're implemented, the new regulations will enforce that both the current generation products, can be both conventional products or new generation products, would have to meet those norms. Second, when those norms have to be met, products from companies like Bosch are basically looked at whether there is enough research and development, whether we are working closely with the customers to be able to give affordable solutions needed for India with quality as a given. I can say we in Bosch are prepared because of our global network as well as our huge R&D base in India. So we have always been providing solutions to our customers, and we believe that we have provided affordable solutions with the Bosch reliability and quality worldwide. So I would say we are ready for that.
Okay. Finally, sir, do you think 15-20% revenue growth is doable for the company given positive like for the commercial vehicle cycle turning and innovation rates?
As you mentioned, that Bosch doesn't give guidance, and there's a very specific question on whether Bosch can do 15 or 20% growth in next year. Without answering that directly, I can only say one thing. Any company, including Bosch, the growth is dependent not just on the company per se, it's dependent partly on the company, which is therefore aspect of market share, but greatly on the ground reality of the economy. So if the economy really picks up, and if you talk about a sustained, for the next 2-3 years of going to a sustained 7 and even 8%, and which would be fantastic for India. And in that, if we see that automotive really does a comeback, I would say Bosch being a very solid player in the automotive market in India, that we would see, even double-digit growth. But whether that's 10% or 12, I can't say. But this double-digit growth for any company, including Bosch, requires primarily for the economy to pick up. And we are very hopeful that the economy picks up. Of course, Bosch very carefully looks at its market share, looks very carefully on acquisitions, and most importantly, we look at very strong, long-lasting partnership with our customers with whom we've had relationship over decades.